This is a Lenovo ThinkPad T495S. As you can see, and the problem that this one has, as I'll show you now, is that someone was carrying something on the keyboard, and unfortunately they then closed the top, squashing the screen, and as you see, this is what you're left with a kind of cracking effect around there. So I'm afraid this one will need a new screen. And in this nice new box, as supplied by laptoplcdscreen.co.uk of London, is the new screen. As you can see, well packaged. And a big shout out to laptopscreen.co.uk, because I ordered this on the Tuesday afternoon and it came in Wednesday morning's post. You can't fault that. Excellent service. Okay, the tools that I'm hopefully going to be using are my old screwdrivers from fiddling wreck with glasses and watches and stuff. And if you've ever worked on mobile phones and the like, then you will have acquired all these little tools, these glorified guitar picks really, which are ideal for hopefully separating the bezel, as you'll shortly see. So with this one, from what I've seen, they're fairly straightforward. We will have to start by removing this outer bezel, and from what I understand, once that's done, it should expose all the screws and the wires. So here we go. Okay, we'll start there. Yep, there's something there. Oh yeah, don't know if this camera will pick it up, but they're just the sort of clip you're dealing with there. That one's just to the left of the camera. Put the camera back there. Come on here, gently. Gently. Must be another one there. Gently. One. Two. Three. Yep. Okay, we're going to the bottom half of the bezel. Now it's a bit trickier to get to. What we found with the other side is you have to be very careful. This plastic bevel is very, very thin and flimsy. You just run your finger along there. And the actual screen is stuck with the black sticky tape to the bezel, so you have to just gently grip the whole shebang. Very, very gently, a bit of pressure, just pull out, and I think we should be out. Okay, having released the, get my strap out of the way, having released the bottom bevel there, a little bit of gentle pressure, you can now grab gently, just pull it ever so gently and then lift it and allow it to come forward. Down onto flat onto the keyboard, and there you have it. That's the back, and I think the first thing we'll be doing will be removing the little connector, which is under this sticky tape. So let's move the camera. Excellent. Yeah, this is a typical laptop computer clip. It's a little spring clip, don't know if you can see that just there, which wraps around the front. And what we normally have to do is just lift that one gently off. Move it back. And then this little plug will need to be moved backwards horizontally to pull it out of its housing. Again, very gently, because these are delicate computer parts. It's just gripping it is always the issue. Oh, that was easier than I thought. There you have it, the screen's out, but we still now need just to remove the thin plastic bezel, ready to install the replacement. Just tidy this up. Okay, as I said, this screen is held down a bit like a lot of mobile phones used to be, with this really thin piece of sticky tape that goes all around the outside. So what I've done is just pried the corner very, very gently. I left a pick under there to keep the pressure on, so I can then use my, I think they call this a spudger or something, just to go along there and break the seal. Oh, that's interesting. You can see the sticky tape just dropping down there. So just prising it apart very gently with my thumb to expose this sticky tape, and just using the point of one of my little tweezers here to just gently pry the tape down. Move it along underneath the circuit board very gently, a piece at a time. Now that's awkward because there's a bit of sticky tape which is linked to the board. Do the other end. Okay, I just had to take a time out a minute just to double check the bottom of the bezel, because he seemed a bit stickier than the top. And that's often the key with jobs like this. It's a little bit of patience. Sometimes you get a sticky bit. Take a step back. What appears to be effective is to use the thin pick. Very gently. Move and twist. Move and twist. Move and twist. Put it down. Move. Twist gently. Move along, twist gently, along, twist, move along, twist, that's doing it, twist. All the time using this thumb over here, make sure the screen stays away from the sticky bits. Move and twist, a bit of pressure, great look. Aha! Yes, it seems to be sticking. It's coming away. Move and twist. Pop. And that was pop. So what went pop? Still have some troublesome sticky tape by the look of it. Okay, so having picked up all the sticky tape, we've now got down to this the bare bones. So this is the screen. I'll just move that back a little bit. When it comes out of the box, there's black sticky tape which comes up and covers up the back end of this PCB, and that appears still to be stuck to the bottom of the bezel at the moment. But if I show you the new one, you'll see what I mean. So that's the screen as it looks with the exposed PCB there. In the bag is the new one. There you go. So the new one, see, you have a sticky tape. There's your little switch, little connector. The sticky tape covers up and covers up both the front and the back, and it's this piece which is stuck to the bezel, so I've just got to pry that off now. Aha! It appears to be stuck under the sticky tape. Yep. I just have to get another tool a minute. Okay, so having had a look at it, the black sticky tape, as I showed you on the new one, which covers up the PCB here, what appears they've done originally is they've put the sticky tape, which covers the entire bezel, over that sticky tape which was glued in place. As I'm a bit miserly, you know, penny saved and all that, I'm trying to reuse the sticky tape. So what I'm thinking of doing is I'm just going to take a scalpel and very carefully just cut a neat line along there to separate the screen, and the new one should go in. You can buy the sticky tape. This is a kit I bought a few years ago for doing mobile phones. And in there is a roll of the very thin sticky tape with the protective screen on it. But that's a sticky tape that actually goes around the inside of the screens of your phones and this laptop, if you need to get any more. So anyway, let's just separate this one a minute. Let's get some extra light, I think. Okay, just trying to keep a little bit of tension on the bezel. It makes it easier for the knife to run along in a straight line then. Boink. There you have it. One broken screen. Just check the old and the new. Let's turn it round. Let's move that bezel a minute. Here's the old screen with the exposed PCB and the sticky tape I've now cut off. And the nice new one. There you go. So, let's try and pick this up one-handed. Space. Fetch the bezel back. Okay. And now we have to try and get the new one into position. And we think I might have to take the protector off before I flip it over and put it in. Church of the Poison Mind. Anti-8 guns. Okay, with the protector removed, it's now just trying to line her up. Okay, that was a little bit trickier than I thought, just lining it up. There are two little lugs there, one that side, and it just sits above it. But I found to actually put it in neatly, it was easier to put the screen on its back and then lay the bezel over the top. You can then line the points up, that corner there, with the corner of the screen underneath. Otherwise you see a little grey edge. So you line that corner up, and then just gently place the screen down, and she's ready to go back in. Okay, now for the fiddly bit. Let's put it back together. I've just put a cloth over the keyboard to protect it. Want to put this clip back in. You don't get a lot of leeway with these, so it's pretty awkward. And you've got that little pin keeps dropping back down, which is rather annoying. Yeah, like that. Try and just get these pins lined up horizontally. That might be it. Put the retaining clip back down. Sticky tape. Then lift it up. Okay, so before we clip the bezel back in, and there we have it. Lenovo. All looking good. Edge of the screen look good. Excellent. I think we'll just power this one off a minute. Good night. Let's pop that bezel back in. Get the camera sorted. Reverse the process. Put the screen up. That camera goes down there and between the two hinges. Ah, oh. Oh, that's interesting. You can see that some of these little clips the top here actually locate into these little recesses, so in theory it should pop back in. You shouldn't get it wrong. Famous last words. Okay, let's do the side first then. Down, squeeze, down and squeeze. Turn up on the side. Tricky, why don't that sit like there then? Look at that one. Aha. Ah, just needs to be guided around the bottom. So that one there. Squeeze, push and squeeze, push and squeeze, push and squeeze, push and squeeze. And that one, just use fingernail, pry it back. There's a little clip there, just see it with a little hook on it. It needs to sit underneath. Push and squeeze, push and squeeze. And that is that. Do you believe? We'll just check around there. Yep, looks good. Another happy customer. Right, final check. Success. There we have it. So, not too taxing a job, but you will need some basic tools and a scalpel. If you're taking off the original one, which is stuck in, you will need a scalpel to separate the screen, as I showed you. Torch is always handy, but no, basically that's it. Nothing more complicated really than these, a spudger and your picks, and it's done. Another happy customer. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found it helpful. As I said, a big thanks to laptoplcdscreens.co.uk for supplying the new screen and supplying it so quickly. Thank you very much.